And while my students may think I'm psychic, I'm not. When I met him, his mere smile showed me that even in the midst of trouble, that there is still so much hope. Now, Jean Kerr said that hope is the feeling you have, that the feeling you have isn't permanent. And that makes a lot of us think. We've all been in situations that have honestly left us in tears. And the message that he'll bring to us today will tell you a little bit about his journey. Now, Mr. Brand, from the tender age, always wanted to do odd jobs. So he would rake leaves, he would mow lawns, anything that he could do to become an entrepreneur. Well, his business came to a screeching halt when he contracted spinal meningitis at the tender age of 14. That actually left him paralyzed from the waist down. Now, most of us would probably give up in despair, but not him. He went on to found Ray Rand Apparel, which is a clothing designing line that you can actually get online. He also received a full scholarship to play wheelchair basketball at Oklahoma State University. And not only did he play basketball, but he also earned a bachelor's degree in entrepreneurship. Now, he has done mass mentoring for partners with disabilities. He's also done countless work with other youth in the community. Now, one of the things that he said is being in a wheelchair, even though for many people would give him a setback, he looked at it as a new perspective that the world must hear. He said that he is a living testimony and a reminder to all those who aren't able to see it in themselves that they are truly indeed grand. It is my absolute honor and privilege to welcome speaker, author, entrepreneur, and motivational guru, Mr. Ray Brand.
Thank you, Shay, for your kind words, your warm heart, and your beautiful soul. I appreciate you. Good evening, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I'm honored to be here today. I'm elated. The greatest weakness of a person is fear. The unknown. Not knowing what can be. But not today. Today, you're a proven success. I put in your countless hours of your practice, your homework, consistently coming to class. This is something that nobody can take away from you. Not a soul. You overcame fear. With all the obstacles that you came encounter to, you didn't give up. And I'm proud of you. And you should be proud of yourself. I'm gonna share a story with you, if I may. Can I share a story? All right. So I remember when I first got paralyzed, I was laying down in my bed. And obviously it was a wheelchair, and my wheelchair, and I was looking at it. I really can't get into my wheelchair because I'm paralyzed. At least I thought I could get into my wheelchair. That was my first thing, can't do it, because my body couldn't move. So, physical therapy would come into the room, and one physical therapist would come behind me and put their arms underneath, like my armpits, and then another physical therapist would grab my legs and then lift me up and put me into my wheelchair. So, to be honest with you, at the time, I'm like, I played it cool, I smiled, like, it's gonna be all right. But honestly, when the lights turned off, when I was in that hospital bed, I was very hurt. I was very discouraged. And I didn't really know what to do. So the only thing that I knew that I had to do was pray. And I cried out to God, praying that for a better life and trying to figure out what am I going to do with this life. And He told me, just take it day by day, just take, I'm gonna take care of you, just take it slow, just calm down, relax. So that's what I did. And so the next day, I would start to play with my legs, because I remember I'm paralyzed in my balance. I would start to play with my legs, trying to get my balance. And then I would put my legs on the edge of the bed and try to hold myself up. And then the next day, I would put my arm on the wheelchair, and then my legs would be hanging, and I'm holding, trying to transfer into my wheelchair. Remember, I can't get out of my bed, at least I thought. And then the next day, I was like, you know what? I gotta get into this wheelchair. And so the physical therapist provided me with a sliding board, which is a board where I put underneath my butt, and I put it on the wheelchair, and I had my arm and then my legs, and I would slide on the sliding board, and I would get into my wheelchair. And so I would practice that every day, getting better. But I still wasn't really happy. And waking up in the hospital, I remember sleeping, and I had the blanket over my head. And a nurse came in. She said, "Good morning, sunshine. Good morning, Ray." I said, "What? Good morning. This is a great morning." Like, yeah, just her voice, her energy, everything about her lifted up my spirits. And I was like, "Yeah, good morning. What are we doing today?" "So we're gonna get you in the shower." I said, "What? Yeah, we're gonna take a shower. Let's go. I'm ready." Now I need to get up and get in my chair a lot faster. Honest to God, I got in my chair a lot faster. So when you think about that, you think about that process. The number one thing I did, I put God first. The second thing I did, I believed in myself. And there's always someone, one person that motivates you, that pushes you the extra time, that gives you that extra push. They don't need to do anything sometimes. Sometimes it's just their mere presence. And so that's what that nurse did for me. And that was not the first obstacle that I came accounted to. And so today, you graduated. It's great. But in life, you will encounter more adversity. But you have to remember today, you are a proven success today. So that means when another adversity, another obstacle comes, guess what? You did it already, you can do it again. So that I say to you is that you never give up. You never, never, never give up. It sounds good, you hear it, but you have to believe it. Believe it so much that if something comes your way, you say, "Oh, I already knew it was coming." Expect the adversity, expect it. Once you expect it, then it's a little bit more easier to keep going. I was very honored with Ms. Shay, Stephanie, and Jennifer Young to take advantage of the services. So to the skincare, you got me ready for GQ magazine. So thank you very much. And for my nail care, every time I touch anything now, it turns into gold. Honestly, God. and massage therapy. Massage therapy, you have a huge responsibility. A very huge responsibility. You're not just touching a person's body, you're touching their soul. You're healing their soul. And your responsibility, you would think, would be the other person, but the responsibility is yourself. It's putting yourself first, investing in yourself. Because in order to heal someone else, you have to heal yourself. And so I urge you to love yourself constantly and put in the work on yourself. And I thank you for all massages. That was amazing. And the most important thing for me, receiving all the services, is the love, is the smiles, is the hey Ray, how you doing? I'm doing good. We're talking individually about life, and we're building the questions, and we're going back and forth. That was the most important thing to me, because there's a lot of people that can do pretty much anything, do what you do, but they don't do it like you do it. The way you smile. Every single student smiling, hey, how you doing? I'm like, you guys are ready. You guys are ready to go to work. So what I say to you is to continue to work hard, never quit, put God first, believe in yourself, and everything will come true if you believe it. And I thank you. I appreciate you.